సంసార సాగరే మగ్నం శ్రీమత్ భాగవతాఖ్యోయం ప్రత్యక్ష కృష్ణ ఏవహి స్వీకృతోసి మయానాథ ముక్త్యర్థం భవసాగరే మనోరథో మదీయోయం సఫల సర్వథాత్వయా నిర్విఘ్నేనైవ కర్తవ్యో దాసోహం తవ కేశవా శుకరూపా ప్రబోధజ్ఞా సర్వశాస్త్ర విశారదా ఏతత్కథా ప్రకాశేన మదజ్ఞానం వినాశయా వందే నందవ్రజస్త్రీణాం పాదరేణుం అభీక్ష్ణశః యాసాం హరికథోద్గీతం పునాతి భువనత్రయం వందే నందవ్రజస్త్రీణాం పాదరేణుం అభీక్ష్ణశః యాసాం హరికథోద్గీతం పునాతి భువనత్రయం.
The next bhakta we meet is a person called Bhishma. You will agree with me that Bhishma is a character to be reckoned with. Sometimes even in the opposition party you have good people, you understand? Even in the opposition party you have people to be reckoned with, and Bhishma is one of them. He has a bad boss, but he is not bad. This Bhishma is lying on the bed of arrows and everybody is standing around him. The last scenes of the earlier version of the Mahabharata, unforgettable it is. Everybody is standing around him and he's looking. He's looking at the Pandavas. Pandavas, how much you suffered. The man who is lying in the ICU, if he is allowed to talk, he confesses all his faults and asks for pardon, isn't it? On deathbed, we are conscious of all our faults and we seek pardon for all our mistakes, past mistakes. That is what the great Bhishma is doing. I had a bad boss. I had nothing against you. My children, Yudhishthira and brothers, I had nothing against you. Everything was done by Kala. Sarvam Kalakritam Manye. I think it was time which was playing havoc in your lives. So please remember,
సర్వం కాలకృతం మన్ని భవతాం చ యద ప్రియం సపాలో యత్వశే లోకు వాయోరివ ఘనావిలి.
అండ్ లెట్ మీ టెల్ యూ మై డియర్ చిల్డ్రన్, ఐ కుడ్ నాట్ టెల్ యూ ద ట్రూత్ బికాస్ ఐ హ్యాడ్ అ బ్యాడ్ బాస్ ఓవర్ లుకింగ్ మీ ఆల్ ద టైమ్. దిస్ వన్ హూ స్టాండ్స్ హియర్, దిస్ కృష్ణ, దిస్ బ్యూటిఫుల్ కృష్ణ, దిస్ హ్యాండ్సమ్ ఆఫ్ హ్యాండ్సమ్స్ కృష్ణ, he is not a coward boy. He is not the flute player of Vrindavan. He is the master of the world. Your mother made him a part of your family. He became a total part of your family, serving you day and night. He esha vai bhagavan sakshat adyo narayana puman. You had the Vishnu Sahasranamam chanting. Please clap for those who chant every day. Because the Vishnu Sahasranam tells you he has 1,000 names, and all these names from the shloka are there in the Bhagavatam. Esha vai bhagavan sakshat adyo narayana puman. He is the one. This is not a dying man's delirious declaration. I am telling you, I am clear headed with all my conscience. I am telling you, consciousness, I am telling you, this is Krishna, the master of the world, who came to serve your family. My dear children, you are lucky because the Lord was monopolized by your mother. Master of the world became a servant of your family. He came as a servant of your family. The dasas of Karnataka say, If you carry flowers for him, he carries hay for your cattle. He'll bring hay for your cattle if you carry flowers for him. That is the way the Lord can be a vrittya vrittya. After that comes the great advising session where you have Dharmaraja listening to all the advice given by Bhishma, and that is on Dana Dharma, Raja Dharma, Moksha Dharma, Stri Dharma, Bhagavad Dharma, and then of course the Vishnu Sahasranama. After that, Bhishma says, Krishna, stand before me. I have to tell you something. Swan song, the last prayer. I have to bid goodbye. And while I'm bidding goodbye to the world, stand before me. Who can command the Lord? Only a bhakta can do it. Stand before me, Krishna. Don't look daggers. Don't look angrily at me. I didn't offer you patram, pushpam, phalam, toyam. I offered you bana, Krishna. Bana. All the banas that I aimed at Arjuna, you rose and took on your lovely cheeks until your face was bleeding in the evening. Forgive me, Master. I was just doing the soldier's job. Ours is not to question why. Ours is not to make reply. Ours is but to shoot and die. That is what the soldier does. I had to do it because my boss commanded me shoot. And I had to shoot, Krishna. I crave pardon for all that impertinence, my Lord. All that impudence. Atrocity committed by me. Krishna, the moment you came onto the battlefield and you gave us one sweeping look, we knew the hit list was ready. We knew for whom the bell tolls. In the 11th chapter of the Gita, like a very clever teacher leaking out the question paper to his favorite student, Krishna is telling us who is going to die. Dronam cha bhishmam cha jayatratham cha. I envy Arjuna. The question paper is out. He knows who is going to die and the order of the death also. How do you like it? Don't you envy Arjuna? Don't you envy Arjuna? Here is Bhishma saying, you gave us one look. The look of the Lord is something very peculiar. In the Tamil language, it's called Kanna. Because he's got meaningful eyes, lovely eyes. All of us know that in a personality, the eyes are very important. Sarvendriyanam Nayanam Pradhanam. He who has got lovely eyes, what is the power of Venkateswara's eyes? Venkateswara's eyes can make a cancer patient live for 20 years. Please clap. That is the power he has. He can make the dying man live on and on. The same time Krishna's eyes can make the enemies of Arjuna die. With your eyes, you stole away our longevity, says Bhishma. Our Ayush was stolen away by you, Krishna. One day my boss came into my tent and called me a traitor. And I said, Duryodhan, how dare you talk to me like that? And then I told him, you think I am not a loyal servant of yours? Of course not. You take your pay from us and you owe your allegiance there. You go every day to the battlefield and you don't kill a single Pandava. That shows you love them more than you love the Kauravas. He shouted at me, Krishna. He insulted this gray beard in the 80s. And I told him, watch out today, Duryodhana. I will cause havoc on the battlefield. If I don't bring back the head of a dead Pandava, I'll make the non-fighting Krishna take up arms. And if I don't do that, my name is not Bhishma. I thought it was Duryodhana listening. I did not know it was Duryodhana's Antaryamin Damodara who was listening as I came on to the battlefield. Master, fury incarnate, myself an army, old man fighting like a young man. Everybody was running helter-skelter. When Arjuna's chariot, your chariot came in front of me, Arjuna was nervous. He could not hold his bow and arrow. Everybody started running here and there. The heavens were trembling. The earth was trembling. You jumped out of the chariot and your upper cloth, Uttariya, was trailing behind you. You walked 10 steps, Krishna, Arjuna held your foot and said, no, foul, my lord, foul. That is one of the conditions of yours before the war began, that you will not take up arms. And yet you, Chakrapani, took the chariot wheel on your shoulder and you were coming towards me because you broke your vow to keep my vow. 1,000 namaskarams to you, Krishna. 1,000 namaskarams to you. Swanigamamapahayamatpratignyam ritamadikartum avapruto rathastaha drita rathacharanaha abhyaya chalatguhu haririvahantumivam gatottariyaham. When you go to a Kerala temple, my brothers, you have to take off your shirt because you are a slave. Only a slave should not wear an upper cloth. Like a slave, Krishna, even with the uttariya falling down, you are coming towards me, Krishna. You are coming towards me. That is the way Panduranga and Krishna, different forms of Krishna, are with the Lord, are with the devotee, as the Lord is the devotee's devotee. Who can forget Guruji saying, when Janabhai and Namdev give us this beautiful kirtan, Mother Janabhai says, Namadev kirtan kari.
Namadeva, Namadeva kirtan kari, prema bharanachi panduranga. Namadeva, Hari Namadeva, Hari Hari.
Namadeva kirtan kari, prema bharanachi panduranga.
Janabai mane deva, bolu abhanga. Janabai mane deva, bolu abhanga. Namadeva, Namadeva, Hari Hari, Namadeva. Nachat, Hari dolat, Hari nachat dolat devata, galala pitambar. Hari nachat, Hari dolat, Hari nachat dolat devata, galala pitambar. Savat hoi deva aise bole kabir. Savat hoi deva aise bole kabir. Namadeva hari hari, kirtan kari, prema bharanache panduranga. Vittala Vittala Panduranga, Jai Hari Vittala Panduranga.
Vittala Panduranga, Jai Hari Vittala Panduranga.
Bhakta Vatsala Panduranga, Bhagavata Priya Panduranga.
Bhakta Vatsala Panduranga, Bhagavata Priya Panduranga.
Makara Kundala Panduranga, Pitambaradhara Panduranga.
Makara Kundala Panduranga, Pitambaradhara Panduranga.
Vittala 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 Panduranga.
Vittala 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 Vittala
Vittala Vittala Panduranga. Jai Jai Shri Radhe. Radha's cosmic vision, cosmic efficiency and power, please raise your hand to invoke her. If you are sensitive, you will find the tips of your fingers tingling. Jai Jai Shri Radhe. Jai Jai Shri
Radhe.
Jai Jai Shri Radhe Shyam. There are bhaktas and bhaktas, to make the long story short. The great one called Parikshit is born. Everybody says he is going to be very, very famous in the world. He is going to be like his great ancestors. There comes a time when Krishna decides to leave the world. He decides to come, he decides to leave. And when he is gone, the Pandavas also decide to leave the world. And when Krishna is gone, the Pandavas cannot stay on. Arjuna says, I cannot live in a world without Krishna. I cannot live in a world without Krishna. We are the same, brother. We are the same. And yet we are not the same because Krishna is not there. I compare it to a check. Please write a check with 0000. Can you encash it? We are the zeros. He is the digit, my dear listeners. He is the digit. Without him, we are non-entities. We are nothing without him. We are nothing. We are just nothing without him. Hanumanji knew it. It took 18 chapters for Arjuna to know it when he said, Karishye Vachanam Tava.
My dear listeners, when the Pandavas are gone, Draupadi is gone, Mother Kunti is gone, Vidura is gone, everybody is gone. It is Parikshit who becomes the king. And it is he who has to establish justice. When he comes across evil in the form of Kali Purusha, being a king, he's establishing justice. And he's asking Kali, get away from my kingdom. Kali says, no, sir. As long as the world exists, evil will exist. So long as the world is there, evil will be there. We can only mitigate evil, we cannot annihilate evil. Evil says, I can't go, but give me a housing colony. I will go and stay in that colony. And Parikshit says, one is gambling, one is where there is alcohol, one is where women sell themselves for pleasure, and one is where there is unwarranted violence. That is why it's called Dyutam Panam Striyasuna. And then Kali says, I want one more place. And what is that? Gold. What is gold? Property. Why does man and wife quarrel? Why do men and women quarrel? Because of property. Man and child quarrel? Because of property. Brother and brother quarrel? Because of property. One day, Parikshit goes hunting. When he goes hunting, he feels tired. You know, after hunting, you feel tired and you feel thirsty and you feel hungry. So he enters the hermitage of a rishi called Shamika. When he finds the rishi seated in deep meditation, he can't control his hunger. May I ask you a simple question? You are sitting here for 2.5 hours. You are there, we are here, and yet we don't feel thirsty or hungry. At home, how many cups of coffee? How many cups of tea? How many biscuits? How many chocolates? How much we'll be devouring? Why is it that we are not hungry or thirsty? Because we are drinking the nectar of the Bhagavatam, my dear listeners. People ask me, don't you feel thirsty? I said, I don't. Before the katha, I feel thirsty. After the katha, I don't. There is something that is making my voice, something that is helping my throat speak. I know it's the master's words. It is the nectarine words of the Bhagavata Amritam that is going into us. And yet poor Parikshit can't control his hunger. He does something very, very sacrilegious, blasphemous. When you see a Mahatma, please bow down to him. If you don't bow down, it's okay, but don't insult him. He takes a dead snake and puts it round the neck of the seated sage. Every action has a reaction, and that in the opposite direction. The son of the sage, his name is Sringi. From far he comes to know that his father, who is meditating, has been insulted by Parikshit. Not knowing that Parikshit is the great king of the land, he curses him. Reminds me of John Stuart Mill, who says, one man's opinion against a million is important. Doesn't matter. One man can curse a monarch. You understand the power of dharma? One man can curse the monarch. He says, he who has insulted my father, may he die of serpent bite 7 days from hence. Not this serpent or that serpent, but Takshaka. When Takshaka stings, no, I see you. The man dies then and there. Iti langita maryadam takshaka saptame ahani dangshati svakulangaram chodito meta tadruvam. My dear listener, that is the relevance of the Bhagavatam. It makes you time conscious. Parikshit says, my God, I have only 7 days to live. Time management. Time consciousness is life consciousness. Life consciousness is death consciousness. Death consciousness is God consciousness, my dear listeners. That is the development. That is why we read the Bhagavatam. Let us live for 100 years. But we have to plan. The entire Bhagavata makes you life conscious and God conscious. That is why I love the Bhagavatam. My master Dikshitar used to say, so many people go to bed, don't get up in the morning. T.S. Eliot says, death has 100 hands and walks by 1,000 ways. We don't know when death will come. One trump card that the Lord does not reveal to man. We don't know when death will come. I'm not making the evening grim for you. All of us have to die. One day we have to die, and the Bhagavatam makes us God conscious, so that you start monitoring life. You start going towards values, away from disvalues. Let us live 100 years, but the rest of the life that we have before us, let us have quality life. Life which is the best, life which is perfect, life which is God-centered, life which is man-bound, life which is full of values, life which makes us closer to God and farther from the devil. That is what we have to do. Parikshit is saying, what should a dying man do? That is his question. He gives up all his finery, gives up the brocade robes, gives up the crown, gives up the throne, gives up the capital, and goes to the banks of the Ganga and is asking, what should a dying man do? A lot of sages are seated there. Atri, Vasishta, Chavana, Sharadvan, Arishtinemi, Bhrugu, Angira, Parashara, etc., etc., Narada, everybody. And everybody is asking, what should a dying man do? They say, we don't know the answer. But that man knows the answer. Who is he? His name is Shukadeva. He is the one who knows the answer. Tatra bhavat bhagavan vyasaputru yadrichayagam atamano napeksha alakshalingu nijalabhatushtaha vritascha balair avadhutaveshaha tam dyashtavarsham sukumara pada karoru bakvamsa kapola gatram. He is the one who is coming. His name is Shukadeva. He is very sweet, never growing old. Age cannot wither, nor customs tail their infinite variety. That is what you can talk about the great Bhakta. They never grow old. They grow younger. How is this great man? He's got soft cheeks. He's got lovely big eyes full of compassion. Soft body, soft hand, soft feet. That is how the Mahatmas are, because they have a soft heart within, my dear listeners. That is why they are so soft. And he comes. As soon as he comes, here is Parikshit saying, thrice welcome, Swami. You come uninvited? No, sent by Krishna. Please remember. When does the saint come into your life? When Krishna sends him into your life, my dear listeners. Krishna sends messengers. Krishna sends the great men of the world so that we who are unhappy go towards God, go towards the Master. Janasya Krishnat, Vimukhasya Devat, Adharmashilasya, Sudukhitasya, Anugrahai Vacharanti Nunam, Bhutani Bhavyani Janardanasya. This was the first shloka I heard from Dikshar Maharaj, and this is the first shloka I learned by heart. Would you like to listen to my Master's voice, the only voice I can imitate? Janasya Krishnat, Vimukhasya Daivat, Adharmashilasya Sudukhitasya, Anugrahaiva Charanti Nunam, Bhutani Bhavyani Janardanasya Janardanasya Bhutani Bhavyani Charanti Nunam. He Guru Vairappa. Not mimicry. It's recorded here. Recorded for several decades. It will continue to be recorded. It will never get deleted. That was my Master's voice, thundering voice, which roused the dormant soul to understand what the divine meant. This little girl was 15 when he said, the child will speak. From that time to this time, when I'm an old woman, I remember the voice that has awakened the soul in me. My dear listeners, what do great men do? They take you away from the world of sorrow and make you come toward joy, which is Krishna. And that is why, because you have come, Swami Shukadeva, our whole life is purified. Aho adya vayam brahman sat sevya kshatrabandhavaha kripaya atiti rupena bhavat bittirthaka krtaha. This is the favorite concept of the Bhagavatam. When you go to Ganga, Yamuna, Kaveri, Godavari, and have a bath, you are purified by and by, slowly, according to your karma. But when you see a saint, you are instantaneously purified, fast track. Instantaneously purified. Just as a rich man carries cash and gives whenever he wants, generously, the great saint carries punya. The moment you see him, he gives you ready-made punya. That is why you become purified. You don't have to make any effort. When you see a Mahatma, you say, I met the Mahatma. No, I had his darshan, you see. That darshan is enough.